Hi, this instructional video is about classifying and graphing conic sections. Number one, in order to classify, I have to go over some of the basic rules here. First, you have to understand the standard form in order to classify. It is given as ax squared plus bxy plus cy square plus dx plus ey plus a constant f is equal to 0. Just like when we learned about quadratic functions, you had to identify the a, b, and c to use it to find the discriminant and also to plug into the quadratic formula. It's kind of like that. So first, let's look at this given number 1 and identify the a, b, and c. And you realize, looking at the standard form, here there is no a. So a is 0. And b, identified by the coefficient in front of the xy, there is no b. So b is also 0. And c, identified by the coefficient of the y square, is finally, we have a coefficient of 1. And then we are going to use a discriminant with an uppercase letters, b squared minus 4ac. And let's determine what that becomes. The b, if I go through the process, is 0 squared minus 4 times a, which is 0, times a c, which is 1. And you realize, when you evaluate, you get a 0. So what does this mean? So here are the rules. If the b squared minus 4ac comes out to be less than a 0, a negative number, then there is a choice of becoming a circle or an ellipse. And we'll describe the condition later on as we come about. Otherwise, if your discriminant b squared minus 4ac comes out to be equal to 0, that means what we're going to get for a graph is going to be a parabola, which is the case over here. But let me finish the rest of these rules. If that b squared minus 4ac comes out to be a positive number, greater than a 0 that is, then what you're expecting to solve for and graph is a hyperbola. That's the rule. So in this case, since we have a discriminant of 0, we're looking for a parabola. A parabola, given a conic section where its midpoint is not the center, is given as, well, it depends, x squared is equal to 4py, and that's the basic, where the vertex was at the origin. However, when there's a translation, we say x minus h squared is equal to 4p times y minus the k. And if we have, as a function of y, that is, a parabola that opens either to the right or to the left, is given as y squared is equal to 4px. That's the basic, where the vertex was through the origin. But when we have a translation where the vertex is shifting, we say it as y minus the k. The k always follows the y. Square is equal to 4px, and x is followed by an h in alphabetical order. If you look very carefully, the highest degree of exponent here is for the y squared. So we are looking for an inverted parabola. And so that's what we're trying to make it look like over here. And so we know what to graph. Now we have to make it into a standard form. And we're going to complete the square in order to do that. So let me rewrite the entire given equation over here. And I'm going to group it up. For example, y squared minus 12y. And I'm going to complete the square, given the a and the b term. Now, as you recall from the previous lessons, to complete the square, you take the b coefficient, in this case the 12, or negative 12, take half the b, which is 6, and you square it. Remember? Take the b, take half of it, and you square it, and that becomes a perfect square. So half of 12 is 6, squared is 36. However, whatever you did to the left side of the equation, later on you have to give to the right side as well. But simultaneously, let me move the 4x and the 4 over at the same time. So that becomes negative 4x minus the 4, and then I'm going to add the 36 to both sides of the equation. Now I am able to factor the left side of the equation, which becomes a special product property, minus 6 minus 6. And on the right side, we're going to evaluate the constants, so we get negative 4x plus 32. We're going to start solving for y by writing this in a single term, y minus 6 squared is equal to, and factor out the coefficient negative 4, and what remains is x minus 4 times 8 is 32. And look at that. What we have is now a standard form where the h and the k can be identified as the inverse of a negative 8 is 8 and 6. That's the h and the k. Then what's the p? Well, p is the coefficient in front of the x minus h. In this case, 4p is identified as negative 4. So what on earth is just a p? Well, to solve for p, we divide the coefficient 4. So the p, the focus, actually is negative 1. So then how do you graph this? Well, now the vertex is at 8 and 6. Two, four, six, eight, and two, four, six. Here is the vertex now. And the coefficient is given as a negative, so it's going to open to the left. So let's just do that randomly right here. Meow. Does it go through the origin? I'm not really sure, but I'm just sketching it. Now, where's the focus? Well, from the vertex is 1 unit to the left. Since I went by the 2s, 2, 4, 6, 8, it's going to be over here. So the vertex, the coordinate is 8 and 6. The foci, or the focus, is given as 7 and 6. There's my parabola. There's my standard form for the equation of that parabola. Here's my translated vertex at 8 and 6. And here's my focus. 1 unit away from the vertex, the focus is right here. Here's my vertex. Okay, so now you see the sample of how this works. Now you try to classify this conic section and then graph that. Okay. Let me bring back the standard form that I showed you before, right there. So let's identify the A, B, and C to determine what kind of a conic section is this. So you said A is 1. B, there is no B. And C, unlike last time, there is no C. But we need to go ahead and do the discriminant, b squared minus 4ac. So substitute in the numbers, we get 0 squared minus 4 times 1 times, unsurprisingly, we get the same thing, is equal to 0. So once again, we are looking for a parabola, because it equals to 0. So we're looking for a parabola. But you notice this one looks a little different. Okay. And so, now we're going to make this into a standard form. And we're going to group it. So, x squared plus 4x. Well, what's half of the b? Half of 4 is 2, and 2 squared is 4. This is going to be the function of x. So now we're looking for a parabola that either opens up or down. Let's do this simultaneously. Move the y term and the constant over to the right side of the equation. So it becomes 8y minus the 12. And since we force the square, we just pulled up a 4 out of nowhere, it's only fair that we give a 4 to the right side of the equation as well. Now we could factor the left side. Now we know it's going to be a special product property. So let me write that as a single term. You should get x plus 2 squared. And on the right side, let's evaluate. So we get 8y minus the 8. And we can make it look like a standard form by factoring the common term of 8 on the right side of the equation. So what we end up is now 8 times the quantity of y minus 1. And since this one is a function of x, meaning it's going to be x squared is equal to 4py, the basic form, and then the standard form is now x minus the h. Remember, the h follows the x all the time, is equal to 4py, but y minus the k. Okay? So looking at the standard form over here, we could identify the fact that now the h and the k, the translated vertex, is now at the inverse of 2, which is negative 2, and 1. And from there, what's the focus? Well, where the 4p is taken up by an 8. So since 4p is taken up by an 8, 4p equals 8, we could solve for p, divide the 4 to both sides, we realize the p is equal to 2. It's 2 units away from the vertex, whatever this may be. So now we could graph it. So the new vertex from the origin goes to 1, 2, and 1. And since this time is a function of x, the traditional way, the parabola, seeing that it's a positive coefficient, and also it's going to open upward. And where's the focus from the vertex? It's 2 units away, inside the curvilinear line. So from here, 1, 2. And the coordinate for the vertex is negative 2 for x, and y is 1, 2, 3. The vertex is at negative 2 and 1. There you have it. There's my standard form for the parabola. There's my translated vertex, hk, at negative 2 and 1. And my focus at the coordinate negative 2 and 3. All the critical points.